Hey guys, my name is Jayson Robertson. I'm a photographer from Sydney, Australia. Today we're going to be diving into some of the brand new features in Adobe Lightroom. I'm going to be showing you how I took my photos from this to this in just a few simple steps. Whether you've been a photographer for years or you're just getting started, these brand new features will for sure streamline and elevate your workflow as well as enhance your images. So let's jump into Lightroom for mobile and get stuck into some of these brand new features. So now we're inside Lightroom for mobile. I've got an image pulled up that I recently took in Istanbul. Before we get started, I'm just gonna quickly apply a preset and then get stuck into the edit. I really love this photo, but I'd like it even more if there were no people in the background. So as you can see, there's a few people in the background. And what we're gonna do is go into the Generative Remove feature and remove these people. So you can find the Generative Remove feature down in the bottom right-hand corner, and it's always turned on now by default. So what we're gonna do is just zoom in, and we're gonna get rid of a few of these people. So you can adjust the brush size to however big you want, and then just quickly paint over the people. And as you can see, it's done a great job removing the people there. You can go into Refine, it'll give you three options, which you can toggle through. I'm pretty happy with the first one, so we're gonna stick with that one. And then I'll go ahead and remove the rest of the people doing the same thing. So just while I go ahead and get rid of the rest of the people in the background, I'm just gonna let you know a few more things about Generative Remove. So it works on both JPEG and RAW images, and it's completely non-destructive. So if you don't like a result that it gives you, you can always revert back to your starting point. Okay, so now we have a completely clean image, free of people in the background. And as you can see, Generative Remove has done a fantastic job of cleaning up the image. Now we're gonna move on to another brand new feature, Quick Actions. Quick Actions is an absolute game changer. It's gonna suggest you edits based on the type of image you're editing. If you have a portrait pulled up, it might suggest things like brightening eyes or whitening teeth. Because we're editing a landscape photo, it's gonna suggest a few things like editing the background or changing the sky. So we're gonna go into the Quick Actions panel, and we're just gonna select the sky, and we're just gonna have a look through some of the options here. So as you can see, it does a few creative edits. So I like the golden hour. I'm kind of going for that golden hour vibe. So I think I'm gonna pick that one. And then let's go ahead and select the subject. And as you can see, it just makes a few edits to the subject. I like that first one pop. We might just leave it like that. And it's done a really great job enhancing the image in just a few clicks. And I just quickly want to point out, if you do plan on using Generative Remove and Quick Actions, do your Generative Remove first. Once you're happy with all your results, you'll have a clean slate on your image, and then you can apply your Quick Actions. So I've just opened up this photo I took in Paris. Just before we get into editing this, I'm just going to apply another preset. So there's just a few things in this photo that I think are cluttering the image, and we're just going to head back into Generative Remove, and we're going to toggle on one of the new updates within Generative Remove, and that is Detect Objects. So now what we're going to do is just zoom into this umbrella here, and I'm just going to roughly draw around it or over the top of it, and it will detect the umbrella. So as you can see, it's done a great job of detecting the umbrella and removing it, and there we go. The image is completely decluttered, and I think it looks a lot better. Now we're gonna jump on to Lightroom Desktop and check out some other brand new features. Okay, now we're in Lightroom Desktop, I'm gonna show you Smart Albums. So if you're like me, keeping your photos organized can be a little bit of a challenge. But with Smart Albums, it'll easily let you search and filter through your images, whether it's a specific event, location, or any images that you've rated. So no more scrolling end on end, hoping to find what you're looking for. Let me show you how it works. So I've gone through some photos that I recently took in Europe, and I've gone ahead and rated the ones that I want to edit with 5 stars. So if I go up here into the search and I click the 5 stars, it's going to bring up all those photos. If I wanted to create a smart album using the 5-star rating, I can click here and I'm just going to name it 5-star photos. So that's going to create an album here on the left. So all those 5-star photos are in there, and it's updated dynamically. So if I go back into the Europe 2024 album and I just pick a random photo and then I mark that with a 5-star rating, it's gonna be added to that smart album, which is right here. And it'll keep doing so if you keep adding more photos with a 5-star rating. I could even create a smart album based on location. So if I was to take a photo in a specific location, create a smart album, and I continue to upload photos from that same location, it would automatically get put into that album. If you're familiar with smart collections in Lightroom Classic, then this should feel very familiar to you. So another feature I'm gonna show you is batch applying presets. So from my previous experience with Lightroom, you had to edit a photo and then copy and paste all the settings and then copy and paste to all your other photos. So now in Lightroom, I'm just gonna switch to grid view. I'm gonna select a couple of random photos. So just holding command and then clicking. Go to the presets tab on the right hand side, and then you're just gonna select your preset and it'll apply the preset straight to those photos. This will save you a lot of time. So now we're going to quickly talk about third-party editing. So for instance, if I wanted to take this photo into another program, you could go to edit in and then browse and browse for whatever program it is that you want to use. Now we've seen this before with Photoshop, and I do this quite a lot with Lightroom. I'll open up a photo in Photoshop and I can bring it straight back into Lightroom seamlessly. But now there's a wider variety of third-party apps available. So for whoever needs to use them, they can take the photo out into those apps and then bring them back into Lightroom seamlessly. Last but not least, we've got content credentials. It's kind of like a digital signature for your images. So when you export a photo, it's going to have your name, your social media handle, and any edits that you've utilized attached to your photo. So let's go ahead and jump in and I'll show you how to apply content credentials. So before we go ahead and export the photo with content credentials, you're just going to want to go to your Adobe Lightroom preferences. And what we're going to do is tick on producer, which will come up with your name. You can connect your social media account and then the edit and activity. And then you want to apply content credentials. Click done, and then you'll be ready to export the photo with your content credentials. So to do that, we're just going to go up to export and then to custom setting. And then down here at the bottom, you have apply content credentials. So once you tick that, everything will be applied and then you'll export the photo. This is a great way to protect our work and to give us credit where credit's due. It's also great for photographers who are concerned about AI transparency or having their photos improperly used. I just do quickly want to note that content credentials is 100% an option and you do have to turn it on for it to work. It's not applied automatically. So that's how I took my images from this to this using the new features in Lightroom for mobile and Lightroom desktop. I love how these new updates help us photographers streamline our process to do our best work. So give them a try for yourself and take your photography to the next level.